But first, the flood battle in the state's north and a second day of torrential rain has overwhelmed pumps and levees. In the township of Tallygaroopna, just north of Shepparton, it recorded more than 70 millimetres in 24 hours, swamping dozens of homes.
After 30 hours without sleep, the prospect of losing her home and business is simply too overwhelming for publican Michelle Emanuele.
Well, I've got a couple of young kids and... I've been up for 30-something hours. I can't do it anymore.
An emotion echoed throughout the tiny town where almost every house has water lapping at the doorstep.
We haven't had any sleep all night. So, yeah, we've just been going and sandbagging, going from house to house and back and forth all over the place.
Never seen anything like it. Normally get rain, but nothing like this.
Tallygaroopna's had 70 millimetres of rain in the past 24 hours. It had about the same on Monday. Utes ferrying stricken residents down inundated streets for their mammoth sandbagging mission, helped by makeshift pumps.
A bit sad. You know, you build a whole lifetime, you know, with your bits and pieces, and I know they're only possessions and you can replace them, but it's still sad to see.
John Pierce and Sharina Flynn are supposed to be getting married this weekend.
We'll be looking for wedding boats, not wedding cars.
It's a mode of transport some have already adopted.
What else can they do? There's nowhere else dry to go, so, yeah, they're having fun in the boat.
While the worst may be yet to come, locals say they're here to stay, determined that these floods won't drive them out of their town.
The communities are very resilient. They're also very loyal to each other.
As I just heard, a bit of a report that they don't expect it to peak until tomorrow. I don't know whether how much truth's in that yet.
That spirit sure to help them through the anxious wait.
Fingers crossed. Everything crossed.
Hermione Kitson, 10 News.